that Sean Campbell was positioned in Portmore when this thing should have been happening. The fact that...
Hola, espero que tengas un gran día. Bienvenido, es Bengo Momento. Wow, wow, my peeps, bless up on yourself. And right now, I have that full voice clip coming up, my peeps. Oh no, don't want to miss this one. Because we still hear attorney for Sean Storm, Bert Samuels. He has expressed his disappointment and really and truly must say Sean Storm was not there when everything went down. So really and truly, he should not be on the inside. That are basically what Bert Samuels has said right now. Him really vexed and upset about the ruling that was handed down at approximately 9:44 a.m. yesterday, Friday. So we see where the three panel judges, they made their confirmation where the appeal is concerned. And Bert Samuels, I say, yo, privy counsel, you know. Yeah, because his client just was not there. Let's listen to what Bert Samuels have to say right now in full details, along with Tom Tavares giving his input as well.
The entire team is grossly disappointed. We are hampered because without a written judgment, very often the court gives this judgment. It's now in cyberspace. We need a 24 hours read of this judgment to see how the court surmounted the difficulties, the problems, the interference with exhibits, the fact that Sean Campbell was positioned in Portmore when this thing should have been happening, the fact that Sean Campbell went into the police three times reporting to show that his conduct is consistent with innocence. All these things for Sean Campbell makes it very puzzling to us. How could we not have had at least even a retrial? This is, slamming us right away as if, you know, we didn't have any great grounds. It must be that the court implemented what is called the proviso, which would be, yes, there were problems, because problems there were, but notwithstanding that, we think that any reasonable jury properly directed would have rendered a verdict of guilty. That is amazing, in my view. I don't see how that could have been a conclusion. But I say, we have to read the judgment. We don't know what the basis on which the court has come to its decision. And to be fair to the court, we need to read it.
I must tell you that this verdict delivered today by the President of the Court of Appeals, Mr. Justice Morrison, has not really come as a surprise to us. Because in this business, you prepare yourself for the worst, but you expect the best. We have been preparing for this day, and we are in the process of preparing the documentation to seek leave to go to the Privy Council, where we are confident that we will get justice. One of the things that is very disturbing about this thing is that it has taken four years, since the jury returned a verdict to get this judgment. So it has taken 4 years for the Court of Appeal to dismiss, but 2 years to hear the appeal, and 2 years to dismiss the appeal. That is not, by any stretch of the imagination, acceptable. And we expect that the Privy Council will have something to say about that.
The process is this. The Privy Council has now adopted a modern approach to arguing appeals. We can video link into the Privy Council. Before the last 2 years, we had to fly to London and argue, which was very expensive for the poor. But what we can do now, at a location, we can argue our appeal in Jamaica and have it video linked to the judges in the Privy Council. That makes it much easier. It makes native lawyers have the opportunity to argue for the Privy Council. And therefore, the process is we'll have to seek the leave, the permission of the Jamaican Court of Appeal to go to the Privy Council. In the event we are denied the opportunity or we don't get leave to go to the Privy Council from the Jamaican Court of Appeal, we can go straight to the Privy Council. But we are hoping that the Jamaican Court of Appeal will say this is a matter of grave public importance. The issues are very important. The phone evidence was new. It was the first time that phone evidence was being used in our Jamaican courts. And when matters are new, when laws are new, it's best to be tested at the highest level, which is the Privy Council.
We have been preparing for this moment for some time. So mentally, Mr. Palmer is prepared to go the long haul. His family is prepared. His father, Shorty, everybody is prepared to go the long haul here. And that is where we are heading to now.
We will be going to the Privy Council. grounds in this matter. We think that there are awesome grounds to argue there. And we are of the view that the People Council will not say, as this court may have said, that the provisos apply, that yes, there were many problems, but nonetheless, the evidence is overwhelming. It could not be overwhelming for Sean Campbell when he's positioned in Portmore. You tell me how that could be.
The judgment is 200 pages long, and when we read it, we'll have something else to say.
Alright, my peeps, so in the last part there, we heard Tom Tavares Finse. He's one of the lawyers for Vibes Cartel, and he is basically stating that 200 pages, yeah, the three panel judges in the appeal really put the reason why they made that decision. So them really and truly have to go through all of these pages to really understand why they came to this conclusion yesterday. But then again, Sean Storm lawyer said the man nothing in there. He just must not be in there. And we see Cartel respond to the whole situation via social media, and he had this post: Gaza Nation, don't get weary. Guess it's time for a trip. You come in. And him hashtag about a thing, bossy slave, all kind of thing, my peeps. But really and truly, right now, Vibes Cartel, him really exhaust resources, you know, fee push this thing so far. Some people are say better Vibes Cartel just do him time and leave that alone, because really and truly, if him go through with this right now, he da go take another whole heap of money, my people. But I'm not going to let them know Cartel pockets steer the end of the day. The teacher just a do way my feet. Do my peeps. So, further right now, we want to talk about Vibes Cartel here with their property and where the residents them have to say, because they must say that the place turning a big dump and they want something be done about the property. Worse, them see say teacher never come back a road. They would even want to see the property sell to somebody who will make use of it or something, but them don't want it in a them scheme like this, because it a harbor. It a harbor all kind of people. All kind of people. You know, madman, etc. etc. Man where, you know, pull things stream, nose and girl we are sell. People will not have nowhere to sleep. Just all kind of madness are going on that property right now. So they must say they want the property to be started out, because it was back in 2015 when we saw the building, the house which Vibes Cartel had there, was demolished. It was situated on Swallowfield Avenue. And why them demolish the house? Because this was where it is said that Lizard met his end. One resident has said, we would really love for the place to be sold, but with that history, who going to buy it? So that's what the resident has said, with everything we're going there, so who going to buy it? You know? And in this, a Lizard never come out after him going, so who going to buy that place? That's basically what the people them ask right now. And we see where the investigators them, even during the trial, said that they found, you know, questionable things on the property before the house was even demolished. A government forensic analyst also testified that, you know, some amount of samples were taken from the home, and those samples were from a male, my people. Yeah. So Crazy situation here, you know. Days after we see them bringing Vibes Cartel back in 2015, the house damaged by fire, and them believe that the house was deliberately set afire to really hide evidence, you know, because them find some, what them call it, accelerant in the place, you know, we speed up the fiery process, my peeps. But comment, let me know what are your thoughts where this situation is concerned, because at the end of the day, we really want just try to keep everybody up to date with what one. Adios subscriptores, es vengo momento.